make welcome your comedian for tonight, Tahir. Thank you. What a nice bunch of audience. Very unexpected. Thank you very much. My name is Tahir. I was born in Turkey. Are there any Turkish people here tonight, by the way? Is that of interest? Just me? Like Gallipoli all over again. And I should talk about Gallipoli because my grandfather fought on Anzac Bridge in Piemont. It was a road rage incident. And this is fantastic. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. This is fun. Like this. Look, don't worry about the elections, ladies and gentlemen. I know no one cares. Do you care about the elections?
No.
No one cares. You're in here having a Christmas party, and I'm sick of those politicians anyway. Like the issues they talk about. The issues. Who's sick and tired about hearing the water problems in this country? You had enough? I've had enough. Oh, we've got the dams are empty. The dams are empty. We'll fill them up. Yeah. Where can we get the water from? Get it from Mount Franklin. Look, I should be a politician. Would you vote for me? I could stop. Global warming. Who's had enough about global warming? You had enough? Oh, the earth's getting hot. Well, turn the air conditioner on. We should have like a world air conditioning day, right? When everybody in the whole world, at the same time, we flick the air conditioners on, world temperature comes down. So my name is Tahir. That's my original name. People say to me, Tahir, is that your real name? No, it was like, you know, Chris, I changed it. Like, people say to me, Tahir, that's an unusual name. That's what they say to me. There's a name you don't hear every day. I do. So this guy knocks on my door and says, excuse me, mate, excuse me, would you like to become Jehovah's Witness? I looked at him and said, look, mate, I didn't see the accident. This is a fantastic country. I can see this room is a multicultural, which is fantastic. Good on you guys. You know, good on the Burton family. Very multicultural. As I said, my background is Turkish. Whatever your background is, it doesn't really matter. Australia's, by the way, I am an Australian citizen too. Proud of this. Where I came here when I was 3 or 4 years of age, grew up, educated in this country. And I remember when I became an Australian citizen, very proud. Like, took a couple of hours. Went inside, got my paperwork. Yes, my whole family came down, watched, waited for me, actually. I went inside, got my paperwork. Yes, Australian citizen. Very proud. I came out. My family said, what happened, Tahir? I looked at them and said, piss off, you wogs. We're lucky. Don't you think Australia's the luckiest country, right? Don't you think?
Absolutely.
You can do whatever job you want here. I can see different nationalities here. I can see some Indian people. Like, there's some Indian people to work with. I love that. I love the Indians, right? I mean, I would love to see the Indians do something completely different with their lives, right? This is fantastic. Don't worry about 7-Elevens, right? I mean, the whole thing is... I mean, like, you know, they reckon the Arabs are responsible for 9-11. Well, the Indians are responsible for 7-Eleven. That's worse. They're right, lit up on every corner. Like, I actually went to uni for 4 years. This is true. I'm a school teacher by trade. I only taught for a couple of years before I do stand-up comedy now full-time and acting as well. So I get to travel all over the country. I love what I do. It's a fantastic job. But teaching was very tough. Right, this is nothing. This is easy. This is the sort of class I have, right? I don't know about you. Casual teaching, which is worse. All right, kids, today we're going to learn maths. Now, it takes 9 guys 6 hours to dig 1 hole. How long would it take 3 guys to dig a hole? They're like, what do you mean? Nine guys 6 hours to dig 1 hole. How long would it take 3 guys to dig a hole? Yeah, like, what do you mean? The other guys already dig the hole. My background is an English drama teacher. That's what I teach. That's what I used to teach, like, many years ago, right? An English teacher. I'm trying to teach these kids grammar. Okay, kids, now who can tell me what comes after a sentence? Why no? An appeal. Can't teach these kids, right? The news is always bad. The news is... And the terrorism. Who's scared of terrorism? Don't be scared. Are you scared of terrorism in this country? Don't be scared. We're safe here. Could you imagine if they try to blow up one of our trains like they did in London or Spain, in Australia, in this country? Yeah, I want to blow up the next train that comes. Don't worry, we're safe here. Like, you know, the government's working for us. My favourite thing to do, and I've been kicked out of Westfields all around the country. I have. I love doing it, and you can try this, seriously. You know when those change rooms? You know those change rooms? Walk into a change room, close the door, very loud voice so everybody else hears you. So, oh my God, isn't that toilet paper? People freak out in the next cubicle. What's going on? people laugh. That's the, if you're driving, next time you're driving, you see a hitchhiker, pick up the hitchhiker, then do a U-turn. You guys have been fantastic audience. Thank you very much and Merry Christmas. Thank you to the Burnham family.